Welcome students to my channel Anglopedia. Today we are going to start with Act 2, Scene 5. So I hope you all are ready with your books. Let us start. Venice, before Shylock's house, enter Shylock and Launcelot. Shylock, well thou shall see, thy eyes shall be thy judge. Here we find Shylock is meeting Launcelot, who has come to say goodbye to him as he is going to work under Bassanio. Shylock felt maybe he is feeling little bad. So he is saying that Launcelot himself will find the difference between Bassanio and Shylock. The difference of old Shylock and Bassanio. What, Jessica? In the mid, he calls Jessica and asks what happened to her. Again, he speaks to Launcelot. Thou shalt not gormandize as thou hast done with me. You don't overeat there in Bassanio's place as you have done in my house. What, Jessica? Again, he speaks. What, Jessica? And sleep and snore and rend apparel out. You go and sleep and snore even in the daytime and tear off the dresses as you have done here. Again he says, why, Jessica? I say. So he, as we find him, once he's talking to Launcelot, again he's talking to Jessica, shows that he's mentally disturbed. Launcelot, why, Jessica? Shylock, who bids thee call? I do not bid thee call. As Launcelot call out Jessica, Shylock got annoyed and he said, who told him to call, told her to call you? Did I tell you to call her? Launcelot, your worship was wont to call me that I could do nothing without bidding. Just now you only said, no sir, that I do not do any work without asking. See, you did not ask me to call Jessica, but I called her. I do the work without saying. Enter Jessica. Jessica, call you, what's your will? Are you calling me? What do you want from me? She asked her father. Shylock, I'm bid forth to supper, Jessica. Jessica, I'm invited to go for supper. There are my keys, but wherefore should I go? So he gives the key to her, to Jessica. And then again he says, but why should I go? I'm not bid for love. They flatter me. They did not invite me out of love. They are only flattering me. But yet I will go in hate to feed upon. He said he would go there out of hatred to feed lot of food the prodigal Christian, that spendthrift Bassanio who wastes the money. I'll go and eat and waste all his money. Jessica, my girl, look to my house. He tells Jessica to take care of the house because he will be out of the house. I am right loath to go. Here Shylock says that he is unwilling to go for the supper. He is mentally disturbed. He is in a dilemma condition. Should he go or should he not? There is some ill a brewing towards my rest, for I did drain of money bags tonight. Here we find Shylock's superstitious mentality. He says, why he doesn't want to go? Because there's some evil being plotted against him. That his mind is disturbed. Because that night he has dreamt a bag full of money, which shows that he was a superstitious man. Launcelot, I beseech you, sir, go. My young master doth expect your reproach. Actually, you want to say approach. Launcelot says, I request you, sir, please go, because my young master will be waiting for you. Shylock, so I do. He's okay, let me go. Launcelot, and they have conspired together. They have made an evil plan. I will not say you shall see a mask. I won't ask you to see the procession. But if you do, then it was not for nothing that my nose fell a bleeding on Black Monday last at 6 o'clock in the morning. Falling out that year on Ash Wednesday was 4 years in the afternoon. Here we find that Lancelot talk has no link, just simply some vocabulary he has learned from somewhere and he wants to pour out that. He doesn't know where and what he has to say. He says here, I do not promise that you will see a mask. But if you see the mask, then I will know my nose bled last Monday, 6 o'clock in the morning in that year. Easter fell on Ash Wednesday just 4 years ago. How can Easter be on Ash Wednesday? We know very well Easter is always on Sunday. How can Sunday and Wednesday be same? So there is no link we find in Lancelot talk. Look, here Shylock says to Jessica, what are their masks? Why? Are they going to have a procession? Hear you me, Jessica. Jessica, listen to me. Lock up my doors, and when you hear the drum and the wild squealing of the very necked five, clamber not you up to the casement then, nor thrust your head into the public street. So Shylock advises Jessica to lock up all the doors and windows, and when she hears the bugle sound of the Christians procession, she should not climb on the windows, put her head out on the main street and see what is going on. All the doors and windows should be locked properly. But stop my house's ears, I mean my casement, let not the sound of shallow foppery enter my sober house. Close all the doors and windows. No foppery sound, no shallow sound or superficial stupidity sound should enter into my decent house. By Jacob's staff, I swear I have no mind of feasting forth tonight, but I will go. He says by the Jacob's staff means by the stick of the Jacob, I swear that I do not have the wish or the will to go for the feast. But what to do? He will go. Go you before me, sir. Say, I will come. Then he tells Lancelot, you please go before me and tell him that I am coming. Lancelot, I will go before, sir. Mistress, look out at window for all these. There will come a Christian by, will be worth a Jewish eye. Then while going, he says, okay, sir, I'm going. And then very softly, he speaks to Jessica saying, madam, please look through the window. A Christian boy will come. To see him, you will be very happy. Exits Shylock. What says that fool of Hagar's offspring? Hagar means devil. He's saying, what that foolish fellow, the devil's son, said to you? Jessica, his words were farewell, mistress, nothing else. No, he only said bye, nothing more he said. Shylock, the patch is kind enough, but a huge feeder, sends low in profit, and he sleeps by day. Then he says, this fool is a kind enough, but he eats a lot. He works like a snail, no profit is there. And in the daytime he sleeps. More than the wild cat, more than the nocturnal cat, he sleeps in the daytime also. Drones hive not with me. The idlers should not live with me. Therefore, I part with him and part with him to one that I would have him help to waste his borrowed purse. So that's why I have decided that let him go from me. Let him go to someone's house where he will waste all the money and the money that he has borrowed from me. Well, Jessica, go in. Perhaps I will return immediately. Then again he tells Jessica to get in. He might come back soon. Do I as I bid you, shut doors after you. Fast bind, fast find. A proverb never stale in thrifty mind. Again he tells Jessica to get in. Close all the doors and windows. And close tightly. If you close tightly, you will find everything safe. Here, really, it is the irony. He is giving all the responsibility, the key of his house to Jessica, who is going to betray her father by taking away all his money and gold. Jessica says, farewell, and if my fortune be not crossed, I have a father, you a daughter lost. Then Jessica says, as Shylock is not there, she says, okay, bye. If my luck favors me, then today is the last my father you will be, and you are going to lose your daughter forever if my luck favors. That means she is going to run away from her father's house. So we have come to an end, children, of this. Now let us see what the importance of this scene. We come across Shylock's character. He always had a fear that the theft of his money. Therefore, he asked Jessica to close the doors and the windows. He had a premonition of something evil is going to happen to his house. It also shows the tender side of Shylock, that he loves his daughter dearly. That's why he tells her to take care of the house. But we find Jessica betrays her father by stealing his wealth. Really, we find here the irony. Thank you, children. If you like my teaching, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.